War, war. Rumors of a war. And until that day, the African continent will not know peace. We Africans will fight. We find it necessary. And we know we shall win, as we are confident in the victory of good over evil.
Survival, you know, we are the black survivor. We don't know. Sounds of Earth Cry.
War in Syria.
I mean, as they say, we have them on as our special guest today.
Hey, in Libya, in Serbia.
International recording reggae band. Earth Cry.
Look in Liberia.
This track is titled Survival System, and we have to play it again, see it?
Survival System.
Yes, sir. I can look up the sense check here, yes, sir.
Oh, me, I tell you. Mindset. Mindset.
Press and say a word, man. Me, I go follow up the reasoning, Zin. Yeah, it's a serious thing. Me don't know how them just take over the thing, sir. I've been saying it's because we as a people, we don't have that structure, you know, to really defend the music. Because for some man now have Bob Marley things and them, I say, boy, that's our 40 grand a piece. Jamaicans, we need to really put things in place, man. We need to protect our culture.
War in Syria. War in Ukraine.
Anyway, sounds of Earth Cry.
Yeah, in Serbia and Bosnia.
With Survival System.
Looking like Syria.
There are special guests today on the program, you know?
In Zimbabwe, the people
we go on in a Mozambique the other day, yeah.
Survival system.
We have to survive it out, you know, man.
Living, we're living, we're living. Living, we're living, we're living. Lord, now. Survival system. Living, we're living, we're living. Living, we're living, we're living. Oh. Take a look in South Chicago. In Rio de Janeiro. Our people.
Move out of the mode still, you know, and live, you know.
We're living, we're living.
And also live to survive.
Living, we're living, we're living.
Cause we survive many a years through a whole lot of things as a people, you know.
North Korea to survive. In America to survive.
And you know, so without no further delay, I'm going to introduce some the bridging them to the Mindset program. Blessed love.
Blessed love.
Yes, Earth Cry, blessed love, warm welcome and give thanks, you know?
Yes, I give thanks. It's a joy to be here, you know?
Yes, the king. And who may I talk to?
This is Aldin, lead singer and guitarist, you know?
Lead singer and guitarist, yes, I. Yeah, man,
yes,
give
sir.
Thanks. Give thanks, my lord. Yes, beautiful
song. Blessed love.
Beautiful song.
Come on, give thanks.
Survival system. One of the items, most recent release, right?
Yeah, it was. Is the album? Yeah. So the album is the most recent release of ours. We're going to have some new stuff appearing this year, but the album was the last release that we did. Yeah.
And that was in what, 2018.
2017 actually.
2017.
Yeah. No, yeah, it was 2018, right?
Yeah, man. Yeah,
correct.
Man. Yes, I. All right. Yeah, man. Powerful song. All right, Mr.
Yeah, man, give thanks.
You know, survival. We survived through a lot of things over many years, and you know, we have to try and move out of the mode now and really start to live life, you know what I mean, and not just living to survive, you know?
Mm-hmm.
What
that is true. If it...
Yeah, go on, my brother.
Yeah, man, you said we need to do more than just living to survive, you know, and them things, those are the kind of philosophies that we have as a part of our liberty, you know, because if you check in deeper tunes into the album, you will see we have a song named Live Good. We tell you, seize the day, you know? Take life by the hands and just live life the best way you can, because you never know when death going to come and take care of yourself.
True.
You see me?
True, true.
So these are the kind of philosophies that we hold close to us and we write in that light, in that kind of regard.
Yes, I. Yes, I. Yeah, man. Powerful, powerful, powerful song. Powerful song. And this song, How the item really construct this song? Because I say, we live out some of the things them that we learn. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So, tell me about constructing this song, because it's a very powerful song. You know, the item I touch all about Panasang. Yeah.
All right, you see now, what I have to go explain to you now is that the songs in Earth Cry right now they are written by me, myself, and Philip McFarlane, which is a keyboard player. This song here, particularly that you're talking about, was written by Philip McFarlane. The best man to explain that would be Philip McFarlane to explain how he, the inspiration for this song stemmed, because this song was written. How we do normally is I will be here in my house, chilling, smoking some herb, jamming with my guitar, have my computer home, recording some things. I write down something. An idea comes to me. I send it to them. And we say, all right, cool, we're going to hit it to the studio. We record together. Same thing happens on his part. So the telling you about the structure of the song from my side would not be fair, because I am not the one who wrote this particular song.
Rasta,
understand?
Right. Yes, I. Clarity.
Yeah.
Yes, I. All right. So, oh, the item really, you know, come about as a band. Cause you hardly really find bands coming out of Jamaica, really. You know what I mean? We see Raging Fire and mm-hmm. other bands like those. You know, how the item come about?
Well, we are college friends, just like Raging Fire, you know, because we all went to the same college together, Edna Manley, and that's how we met, you know. So the thing started from there, and because we had a kind of friendship that developed shortly after the thing. There's just a chemistry that building the thing, you know. Banting is an important thing. Chemistry is very important for banting, you know, in both sound and in both how you relate to one another. So there's just a chemistry that developed. It was just a college vibe, right time, right place, you know, universal thing. Was one of those things.
Yes, I powers. So all of the them go to school together.
Yes, sir.
That is a joy. So the jelly now go on from school day up until now.
From long time.
Yeah, man, that's great. One of the first band, I would say, that really you know, got international with the music as a band.
Mm-hmm.
How much other inspirational them bridging there is to the item?
A lot of inspiration. As a matter of fact, you know, Ibo Cooper from Third World was one of our lecturers in college.
Rastafari.
Yeah. So them man, they tell with the whole breakdown, give the whole 9 yards of the music business from them time till now. So we believe it, them man, they have a close hands-on thing where you come out to Earth Cry in that way. You understand?
Powers.
Yeah, man.
Yes, I strain, because as I said, Third World really them take it international, you know. And really since then we see other bands, you know, bands like Blacker Euro and you know, other bands like those and things, you know, which, you know, mm-hmm. Grammy nominated and so on. All right. The item Uda says is fairly new to the music. How long the, not to the music still, but to the industry in a sense.
Yeah.
How long?
Well, we've been around for about 7 years. This year is I think this year is 7 years. You know, we've been on the scene, you know, doing works and putting out stuff. You know.
7 years.
Together, 7 years together as a band, yeah.
All right. Talk to me about getting the music out there, because we know in a Jamaica for young artists, you know, is a real struggle most of the time, you know what I mean? For get the music airplay and for get recognized, you know, you have a lot of talented virgin and sister in upon the island there.
That is fact.
Yeah, tell me about, you know, getting the music pan the radio, and, you know, people getting familiar with the item.
The way I would describe, the best way if I describe it is luck, right? You know, yeah, man, because the way the music things stay in Jamaica, and you, as you said, radio play, trying to get radio play as a young artist is difficult. I mean, for we music, our music play more internationally than a player at home.
Why is
you
that?
Go outside of Jamaica? I don't know. Because what is the trend, I guess. I guess is what is the trend. And if you're not going to pay somebody for play your music, then... And I'm not... We are not of that mentality. We believe, say, you go and work, and in due time, they will accept you for... After you put in the work. That way, we not going to have to pay nobody. I don't think we should have to... This payola thing is criminal, and we shouldn't have to pay people to get your music played on radio. Them things is criminal when outside of Jamaica, overseas, they play your music for free all the time. You know what I'm saying? Because they actually love the music.
Yes, I. For real. For real. People play the music without, you know, without certain clause. You know, as I said, the payola thing is a clause in the thing. But at the same time, you know, because it's not something that I support. I don't support the payola thing. Because
But also the trend is also, I realize radio stations would rather play music that them have to bleep out a whole heap of lyrics.
Yes.
More time, I don't understand the mentality that they're trying to push on the youths, because you rather play some music that they have to bleep out, whereas some young youths coming and pushing some old stuff, and probably you're sitting down there expecting somebody to play. You have one or a few DJs that love the music out here, you know. I can't, like, especially people like Mikey Thompson from Cool 97, we have to big them up all the while, because them people love the roots music, so them man will play music. But it's just a small handful it's just one of a small handful of DJs that is willing to play our kind of music.
Yes.
Out here. You know? So.
All right. Your fee say added content, I would hire them and push out there. Why it now get the support in a Jamaica?
Probably, you know, because The generation is looking for, this younger generation, them looking for a different kind of message. Them looking for that kind of hype message. But yeah, here's the thing. I used to be a music teacher. My last teaching job was at high school. So I was a teacher in a high school. And I remember one particular class, I was playing some music, because we're going through all the genres of Jamaica, from Mentos, come straight up to reggae. And I remember when we got to reggae, I was playing some Jacob Miller stuff. And one of my students' response was, "Sir, what kind of old people music that you're playing? We want some Alkaline." So I'm realizing now that the generation wants that kind of vibe, that kind of... But we can't even blame them, because that is what the radio gives them. That is what the radio feeds them.
Yeah.
You know, if that is what the radio feed them, then that is what they're going to want. If the radio was feeding roots all the time, Jamaica is a place where we play, I think we play more foreign music than we play our own music.
Watch that. And the foreigners, them play our music more than how we play the music.
That is the thing. Which is, I never understand it, but I think that is kind of the reason, because I guess maybe the content and the kind of vibe, the kind of hype nature, hype vibe, hype energy vibe, that is what them looking for, I guess. That is the only thing I can see, because I don't know what, I don't see what else it could be. Outside of Jamaica, people love the music, so they play it all the time. So I don't know.
Well, it's a serious thing, because you know, as I say, a whole lot of talent there in Jamaica, Zine, and you know they want to be heard. You know, I myself, you know, I play a lot of youth. One of my thing is, my mission on this thing is. To really expose up and coming artists. You know, that is what I really, really do. You know, bring them to the forefront. And the amount of youths that is in Jamaica with talent, and not only in Jamaica, but, you know, true, we are talking about this. So.
Mm-hmm.
And the type of music, the content music what them put out, Zane, is real good music, real, real good music. Some of them is on dancehall beats and stuff, but regardless of the dancehall beat, it have to do with what you're saying. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And them youth, they're not getting a player. Not getting a player. But then again, there's another side to the thing where you have youth today who are coming at the music, Zane, and they don't believe that they don't believe in themselves, I would say. So they will more pay for a money pull up or something like so. Them, you know, going at the dance and get a selector money for play them song, and you know what I mean. And that is it after that.
Mm-hmm. And that is one trend we are not into, we're not going to jump into, because you see, Bob wasn't accepted as home until everywhere is accepting us.
Thank you very much, and, sir.
You understand? Outside of Jamaica is accepting us and receiving us very well. So it's only a matter of time. So we just continue diligently working, doing well.
Yeah, man. I don't know about the signal. Yeah, the signal. As the Virgin said, Bob Marley. Yeah. Bob Marley really. Say Bob Marley really do it, don't it? Yeah, man. Bob Marley. Bob Marley really set it. Bob Marley really set it higher. Till them run away with the thing. Run away with the thing. We could drop that song and try to get the version again.
Them got the clock, but we got the time.
Credit, 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 credit. Red, gold, and green.
Our destination, we will define.
Oh, me, I tell you. Mindset, mindset.
Them got the clock, but we got the time. Our destination, we will define. They never work, but they want to be fair. But by the sweat of our brow, we shall all eat bread.
Of Earth Crier Reggae Recording Banner.
They never work, but they want to be fair.
Jack Tycho Philosophy. Yeah, man, there are special guests on the program today.
Lolly Pay. I'm saying, children, no philosophy.
Today now.
In the windy
sounds of Earth Crier.
Oh. But the weaker ones will surely fall.
May I tell you. Aldine, blessed.
Blessed love, my general.
Yes, sir. Pour another powerful song again, you know.
Yes, sir.
Philosophy. And it does take me forward to what the I did say about the youth when the I had played the Jacob Miller. And him I say, what type of old song this, Zane? And that had show you say, boy, really and truly the roots is lacking.
Rich is right.
Talk to me about the song, because another prolific song.
All right, philosophy, you know, you say? Them say if you don't stand for something, you will fall for anything, you know. You have to, so you see this song, you know, when you talk about philosophy, you know, you have to have something that you live by, and a philosophy that you live by. Everybody have to have something that them live by, a philosophy that you hold near and dear to your heart. Because if you don't have something as foundation, anybody can come tell you anything.
True.
You see me? And swear you and cause you to do stupidness or foolishness or something that is just detrimental to your well-being or those around you. You know? So you have to have something for yourself that you know to be true within your heart. So you have a philosophy that you live by and you stand by and you wake up and you have... It's like... a mantra, if I could use that. You know, you wake up and you say this every day, and this philosophy, this mantra is what you live by every day. And you go out with your head high and know, say, nobody can shake your philosophy. You know? So you have to, when the son says, children know philosophy, the foolish man shall fade away. You know? So if you don't have your foundation, you shall fade away. So have something, have your philosophy, have your foundation, or you shall surely fade away.
Philosophy, I know.
Which is right.
Reality. Powerful song, you know what I mean? Powerful song. And, you know, before the call dropped, the idea that's about is a reason why Bob Marley is really relevant and who he is today. You know what I mean? It's all because Bob of the content of him really a push out there.
Which is right. Bob Marley was a man who do some things in him in the time that he was that other people were doing. It was, you know? So Bob Marley come and paved the way for a lot of new messengers out there.
Yes, to come.
You understand? So people can continue the good works that him start out. And he have a lot of us here on the mission.
Said way.
Yeah, man. Same way, I do it same way. Because the work can't done.
But I feel you in pan a thing, my general. You know, because I did a talk early in the program, before the I-Forward.
Yeah.
Them find some old Bob Marley tape in England, yeah. Zane? Yeah, man. Them find some old Bob Marley tape where a 40 grand a piece now. And I tell you, today, I just not too long see it on the TV, but probably about an hour and a half ago. Them said they find them. Then, some recording, because most of Bob Marley recording was here in England. Then, and them recording there, you have certain songs that, if you wasn't at the event, you wouldn't hear them songs there, because some of them songs, they never even record.
Yeah.
And put out a certain way. Yeah, man.
And a 40 grand a piece.
40 grand a piece, my general. And several well them.
It take time for each other, because to think this man was the people that yeah, never accept until the rest of the world accept him. And now one record of 40 grand. 40 grand, you understand?
But at the same time saying that, you know what I mean? At the same time saying that it show a deficiency within Jamaica, Zane, with how we control our music and our culture. Zane, because if we did have much control over the music, then something like that fine in England, they would have to hand it over to Jamaica.
Hear the thing, we can't have control because we don't have interest. It have to start with, if you don't have interest in it, then we can't have control over something we don't have no interest in it. Because here's the thing. Reggae music is global. And I don't think Jamaica owns it up as much as some. I don't think Jamaica realize the piece of gold that reggae music is. You understand? I don't think we claim it like how some parts of the world. Some parts of the world claim it more than we, if you tell the truth. And this is a realization that I have made from traveling, because when me there, yeah, that's and you probably say a one and two old man or some middle-aged people or the older folks, they say them are rock to reggae. And then when you travel and you see people my age and younger, way, way younger than me, I rock out to some old school reggae, and some of them can tell you the history of some of them tune there. And it make you wonder what is happening with the generation of Jamaica. We don't realize what reggae is to us. So in order for we take control of something like that, we have to first have an interest in what we have, interest in the reggae music enough. So, you know, because we don't even have the interest. So, in what we have, we don't think of it as great as the rest of the world does. That is my personal observation, especially since I've been traveling.
So what role the artists them play, especially the elder artists them now? Because I even mentioned Third World, one of the Virgin, as a teacher. Zane, what role the Virgin them play? Because we create this thing, out of sweat, blood, and tears, and suffering, you know. Far right. Zane, so what role the elder them play now for really get something organized? Because we can see that it need to be organized. Zane, something need to be structured. Because here, I want to go say, all right, watch out. You know what? We get most of my shows them in overseas. Zane, so me not go too worry about what going in a Jamaica, because nothing not going in Jamaica. Me not, most of my thing are overseas. When me a tour overseas, see? So I want not really go have no interest, because him thing the overseas.
No, you know me not go say saying, you know, because, well, speaking from Earth Cry standpoint, We still have interest for yard, you know. But we understand, say, it's a process, because yard honestly don't look upon you until you start make a large name for yourself, a road outside. So there's yard go and get them focused, you know. But you have to start build first. And right now, the truth of the matter is Jamaica can't even buy music, you know. We don't buy music, so we don't support music. We travel and see different races of people with different reggae artists from all sorts of different countries. You understand? And when we see how them people support them, we wonder why one in Jamaica. Jamaica don't even buy music. So,
all right.
As far as reggae is concerned, then we worse not even buy that. You understand? We have to build first. From our perspective, I think we have to build first and do it the traditional way, the way Bob Marley said, a good man is never honored in the moon country.
True.
Until after the rest of the world and I am. So we just have to keep working. It's sad that that is the reality of it, but that is how we have to do it. And then, because me have ideas, you know, I have ideas, especially what I want to do, you know, to bring reggae traffic. A certain kind of. I have ideas about my part and what I want to do in the years to come, you know, where Jamaica is concerned and the reggae scene and the reggae industry in Jamaica is concerned. And in due time, I hope to see those dreams come to fruition.
Selassie, but, I know.
But right now, I can't. The best I can do for right now is work on the mission that I am working on.
All right, for some you know, some young youth, nobody no know from nowhere. Zane and they are them a stand up in front of 10,000, 20,000 people a Rotterdam festival.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to me about, you know, them type of experience there, you know what I mean? Because you have big shows in Jamaica, but you don't really have big shows like those.
Mm-hmm. Because, well, we are come from a place where we not get no show, you know. To the point where them write about we in a newspaper and I say, we not get no show. And they take sympathy power. They pretty much wrote about us. The title, the headline of the newspaper was Hear Their Cry. And we're here not getting no shows. And that was in I think around 2015 after we just released the EP. You know? And then we come from them times to now. So you can imagine how overwhelming experience like that is. And I can't say we get used to it, you know, because we played in festivals in different parts of the world. We played over the world, all over the world, different crowds. So it's not a matter of get used to, but it's still overwhelming to know that, yeah, this little band from Jamaica that been working so hard for Jamaica, see them, is getting this kind of crowd, or playing for these kind of people. And it's more amusing, it's more amazing when you see these people singing.
Yes.
Singing back your song because they know your songs. Them things, that is, the words can't express how that feel.
So that's the eye. Yes, I. A strength, man. A strength. And that's a good, mm-hmm. that's a good thing for really see. You know what I mean? Yeah. One's embrace what we are doing. All right, really? I want to play the track, yeah. You know, we have about 10 more minutes leave on the program. I want to play this track, yeah. It's titled Table Turn.
There will be no more racial war. They will respect
us. Red, gold, and green. Come long, create your life.
Greedy man's well will run dry. And he will watch his children cry.
Oh, me, I tell you.
And he now knows
mindset. Mindset. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man, sons of Earth Cry. Track title Table Turn.
There'll be no rich, there'll be no poor. Classism will be no more. There will be no more racial war.
Me, I tell you.
They will respect
mindset.
Us for
who we are. Mindset.
The greedy man's well will run dry. And he will watch his children cry. And he now knows just how it feels to go to bed without a meal. Yeah. One day, oh, one day, children, we will watch when the tables turn. We'll build bridges, no more war. And the world will be as one. Equal rights for every man. The Middle East will free from war. And the children free from scars. No more health crisis in
America. I say, Aisha, big up yourself straight to me. I say,
no more racism in America. One day, oh, one day, children, we will watch when the tables turn.
I tell ya.
One day, oh, one day.
Why? look like the table had turned though. May I tell you, you know? Aldine. Blessed love. Rastafari.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes, my general. Yeah, man. Yeah, may I say, boy, you know, look like the table had turned.
Yeah, it's all turn, man, in due time, man. Nothing happened before the time, you know.
Nothing happened before the time. A reality.
Nothing happened before the time. I just patience. Patience is a virtue, so we just have to go on and wait.
Yes, sir. All right. The item, the reason why I said that, you know, the item just did America, Zane. I don't know if the item still in on tour in America right now.
No, man, we're on break, you know, so we're the home.
All right. And America is one of them places where we see a lot of our brothers, you know, being shot down innocently. You know what I mean? Innocently.
Yeah, man.
And, you know, we hope that things, you know, we hope that the table would turn. But as I said, I don't say the table really a turn. You know, really and truly. You know, seriously. A thing in a Mozambique, you know, a flood in Mozambique the other day. And you have African countries, you know, donating and giving money to the restructuring of the church that burned down in France. Zane and places like Mozambique. So when, you know, me love the song, and the song, me know what the message of what they try to get out there. You see me, I say, but when we see things like these are happening same way, you know, it don't look like the table really turned far right.
Can't lose hope, you know, because here's the fella, here's what me believe. There was this time ago when me read this book and the yin yang, this, you know, that symbol there. And it talk about how there was this one aspect of it I remember where it was saying, like, one, it's two seemingly separate entities that are one. And what happened is when one energy reaches its peak, it transforms into the other energy. So what may I say right now? You see all of this bull that we see happening, all of this rubbish and foolishness that we see happening. When this reaches peak, as in the worst, you only say you see it getting worse. And if you watch the trend over time, we only see it getting worse.
Yes.
So when it reaches its peak, is when it going to transform into the other energy. That is the change where we are waiting for. So the table are going to turn, you know. We just, I just probably.
Farah, where have it changing or something worse?
Eh?
Why are we changing or something worse?
What? No, it's not going to change or something worse.
But we, it's not going to change or something worse. We don't know. In all honesty.
Well, truth, we don't know. But me, I strongly believe that we have, based on that philosophy, that we have positivity to come.
Yes.
You know, because we are endure a lot of negativity. There's going to be a change, you know. And if you notice over time, as a nature work, whether it's human nature, mother nature, whatever nature, so nature work. After a time, everything must start over again. It's a cycle. You understand? It's a cycle. Everything must start over again, and we're going to start. Let's picture it this way. You get old and you die, and you're reborn into innocence again. So you start back from a platform of innocence before you get older again into the foolishness, which is what we are living in today. Yeah. So call that adulthood.
Yeah.
Isn't it? I don't know if my symbolism I make way to you. Understand?
Sense, man.
Yeah. I just believe, say, I personally believe we live in a realm where positive things exist and negative things exist. We can't have a world where is purely positive. It's just the realm where we live in. I believe some, there's probably, I don't want to sound like me, I get into some spaceship, otherworldly thing, but there are probably some other dimensions out there, if you don't believe in that thing. But we live in a dimension where things are relative. You're going to always have bad and you're going to always have good. You know, it's just...
far right, a reality, you know, because the you have a negative side, zine pan a battery, and you have a positive side. And when you put in a battery in a whatever, it go and light, it go and light up, or it go and power up. What? So the positive and the negative is a balance. Them need each other for work.
You can't know what one is without the other. You can't know what the positive is without the negative.
Yes.
You understand? So all of that negative that we are experienced is so we can appreciate the abundance of positivity that is to come. That is how me view it. Because it's coming, you know? It's coming and it's coming in abundance. So all of this negativity that we are dwell in right now, where I live through, is just to prepare us and make us appreciate the positivity that is to come, the abundant positivity that is on this way to us right now. You see me?
So last year, I know. Yes, I. Yeah, man, well, we hope, you know, we hope that you know, things will turn out in the way that we want it to turn out to, because
it shall be so, man. Speak it into being. Word is for, you know.
Yes, I. So last year, I know. Yes, I. Reality. Reality, my general. And you know, say we run out of time though.
And one of them things there is, we know it going time the reasoning take hold in egg.
I tell you.
One of them things, man.
I don't know how the management come up and say, oh, yeah, but yeah. All the time. But we give thanks to the moment and the reasoning, you know. It was a great honor for really.
Yeah, man.
You know, have the hype on the program. You know what I mean? I want
give
the, you know, pass me love to the rest of the virgin them, you know, and tell them to continue keeping.
Yeah, man, most definitely.
What the eye them I do, because what the eye them I do is powerful, you know what I mean? Very powerful. Very powerful. And
yeah,
love
man.
The energy. Zin. So you don't know when the eye them there in England, yeah, or in Europe, yeah, we have to link up one at a time, you know?
I mean, man.
Yes, I.
By the grace of Jah, it shall be so.
So last year I know. Yes, I.
Yeah, man.
Yes, my general. So what the people can find the item, you know, in terms of bookings and, you know, any other for me.
Yeah, man, well, you can find us all over the internet still. But if you want to get to us, you can shoot us an email at earthcry, earthcry@gmail.com. Or you can just hit us up on Facebook or Instagram. That's Earthcry. The handle is Earthcry for everything. EARTHKRY. Same handle for Facebook. Same handle for Instagram. Can check out the music online. It's on Spotify, iTunes, whatever, Amazon, you name it. It's out there. So you can check out the album and the EP. And we got new stuff coming out for the Massive this year. So get yourself prepared for that.
Rastafari. Yes, my general. I'm more love and strength, man. And give thanks again for taking the time to forward and reason with you upon the Mindset program. Zin?
Yeah, man. Anytime. Blessed love, my general.
Yes, I. More love and strength. Manners and respect.
All right, my boss. Peace and love.
Yes, John. We're out of time, but we are going to touch that one. You see it?
Yes, John. Foolish man built his house upon his